Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and today in this video I will tell you how to speed up your computer. If you have a lot of lags, freezes in games or just in programs, this video is for you. I will tell you how to delete something unnecessary that exists in your computer, in the memory of your computer, that will help you get rid of this freezes, lags and so on. Well, so let's get started, and if the video will be helpful or just interesting maybe, or I don't know, subscribe the channel please, make the red button under the video gray. So let's go. First, we have to understand why does this happen. When you use the computer, some programs work in background that you don't see them working, like even here, like for example this. I don't know what is this, but it works and it uses my memory, my productivity of my computer. And the second problem is some programs, not some in fact, but most programs make temporary files that will never be used by them anymore. But they use the memory of your computer, especially hard drive. We'll go to two like things. First, we will try to stop that processes that work background, and the second, we will delete the temporary files. So first, we have to understand where are the temporary files and what uses our computer hard drive and video card, processor and some other things. Well, as I have already shown, the first thing is the default Windows resources monitor. Here we can see how many processor is used, how much random access memory is used, and all the processes and how much are they used. In fact, this isn't all processes, but it is a big part, I will say like this. And you can just stop, for example, this. I don't know what is this, but it uses 30 megabytes, so I will just stop it. I don't need it. Well, so the second thing is these two programs. First, for example, let's start with Spetsy. I don't know how it is written, how it is named. So here we see how much CPU is used, how much video card is used, and the temperature. So if you understand something in it, like you can use it, for example, if you play some games, like for example, in, you know, Grand Theft Auto 5, Fortnite, or Minecraft, you can change the graphics. And you should monitor your video card here, and if you see that it is like 90% used, you have to decrease your graphics a bit. And even if it is very hot, you also have to decrease it. I think it's obvious. So this program is very important for just setting up the games, setting up the programs so that they didn't use a lot of video card, processor, or other resources of the computer, because you can see practically everything here. So how do you install this program? You go to their website. I will provided in the description, of course. It is this website, Spetsy, I don't know. And we download the free version, of course. If you want, you can buy the professional licensed version, I don't know. Maybe you can find the cracks, some it's to you, but I think that the default, the free version is more than enough, in fact. It provides enough information. I have it and it's okay for me. You just start the executable file you have just downloaded. After pressing the button, you just saw it on the screen. And you press the install button here and it will install everything you need. So I don't think it's very hard. As I already have it, I will not install it the second time, but I don't think it's a big problem. So the second program is this tree, maybe, WinderStat. It's the program that helps you analyze your disks and find out how much memory is used and what files use this memory. So we press like OK, and it counts all the files or our disk. I have chosen disk C, so it counts all disk C. And here we can find everything that uses the memory on disk C. For example, you can open like, I don't know, FFmpeg for example. And you see that the folder bin uses practically all the memory. It is good for cleaning your hard drive. It should be also important, and it will also speed up your computer if you clean your hard drive. And it is very helpful, like, you have a folder where there are a few hundreds of folders, and this program will show you which of them use the most, the biggest part of the disk, of all the memory. So you can open and like see all this. And just clicking on all the folders, you can find what uses the most amount of memory in your computer. For example, it's you. I know where it is, so I will just show you. For example, users, my user. It also shows the, something like a graph here. It's AppData, it's roaming, Adobe, common, and here media cache files. It's very. It's a cache of Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Premiere Pro, After Effects, and some other programs. If you use them, you may have some cache here too, so it is worth to delete it. You can make it through the program, one by one files, like press delete and delete it. And you can make just like open your, I don't know how it, is it called. You go to the needed folder that you found in this program, and just go roaming for, as I opened here. You open Adobe, Common, and media cache files. You see them, and you can delete them like this. I will not delete them because I need them for projects of the of my videos. So, but you can do that if you have a lot of things here that are not needed. This is all that this program can help us just to clean our hard drives. So we close it. How to install it? I didn't show. Special will close. And we go to this website and press the download button. As all other programs, we wait a bit. Like here it is, 3 seconds, 2, 1. Great. It downloads the executable file. We execute it, we confirm that we want it, we accept the license agreement, we press next, next, choose the folder and press the install button, it will be installed. I will also not do it because I already have this program, so I don't need it, but I think you will manage to install it yourself. So next three programs is Driver Booster, Advanced System Care, and CCleaner. You can also install them all from official websites. Well, I will show the it before I explain the programs. So we go to CCleaner website, download it. I have it Russian. You maybe you will have it in English, I think. So if not, you can change language here. Well, you download it, you execute it, you confirm. It unpacks, and now the installer will be opened, and you can press the install button and install CCleaner. I don't think it's a problem. So the second program is Advanced System Care, and it's like this. I recommend Pro version, of course. It will not be full because you don't have the license, which costs $20. It's rather much for the program. Well, you can find license keys, of course, in the internet. But I don't think it's needed, because default features is more than enough for cleaning a lot of memory in your computer. A lot of, I don't know, not only memory, but a lot of files on your computer. A lot of increase your efficacy of your computer resources. Well. We execute the installer and press the install button here. I also have it in Russian, but you will have it on English, I think. Well, you can find English here. English, and you will have install button here. Great. So, we install this tag. The next is Driver Booster 7. We also download it. We execute the file that we downloaded, we confirm. And then we wait a bit. And here you also have it, I have it on Russian, but you think I think you will have it on English. English, and you press the install button here. And I don't think you'll have problems with it. So after you install these three programs, we can use them. Obviously. Well, CCleaner. Let's open CCleaner first. Here there are a lot of features. You have some options. Well, you can click here, you can look what it is. Well, cookies, some. Well, tools also. Interesting things, but like you can uninstall programs using CCleaner, you can start change startup using here. Like, well, it will not start up when I turn on the computer. You can use disk analyzer, but Windows start is a lot better, I think. Well, so you can click here, like, and use it. It will not give you a big increase in efficacy of your computer. Something that will give a big improvement is these two features, Cleaner and Registry. First is Cleaner. It just deletes temporary files, browser histories. So delete some files from your hard drives that can be deleted, like temp files. I didn't show them, but I think you know what do they mean. Like if you open app data, you can go for example, not roaming but local, for example, temp, and here there are a lot of files that can be just deleted. It's just temporary files that are not needed by the programs, and you can delete them and CCleaner will do it for you. So we start the cleaning and it will delete some 2 GB of memory. It also empties the recycle bin where there were a lot of files, and it's 2 MB were cleaned. 2 GB were cleaned. So it's rather useful. So the second feature is Registry. It allows us to fix the issues in our registry. Like you can make it yourself, like by hands, opening regedit and seeing it all. But CCleaner will make it for you. We press the scan for issues button, and it finds some issues. I have only one because I do it frequently, and you maybe will have a lot of them. Then we press the fix selected issues. You can make the backup, but I don't think it's needed, so I press no, and I fix the issue. If you have more than one issue, you will have the second button here that allows you to fix all issues at once. So we close it, and it's all. We can make it again. Well, I will conceal, I don't want to wait. So we close the CCleaner, we used everything there. So the second program is Advanced System Care. We open it, and first we will have this page. We'll translate it to English also. Well, here we can scan you. I recommend you to select everything here. Because why not? It will all speed up your computer, it will not be bad, so it fixes all security, internet, system optimization, disk, the same temporary files, some startup optimization, and everything. You can read it here, so we just press the scan button. It will be rather long, so I will stop it like now. Maybe, well, it found 2 startup items, a lot of privacy traces. So, it found something. Well, as I stopped it, didn't find everything, but it found just something. So, then you tick everything that you wanna fix and press the fix button, and it fixes all the issues it found. So, It will, of course, speed up your computer. Well, it's all with this program, I think. Well, speeding up is like useless. It doesn't speed up as much as Driver Booster 7 does, so we will use all these four features in another program. Protect, well, I don't really use it, I don't know what it is. Well, you can read. I think you will understand what it is, so I don't think it should be used. And the only thing it should be used, the only thing I have to say it's about this software update. Like, I have WinRAR, for example. I don't have license to WinRAR and license to Windows, as typical Russian. Well, whenever you go, you will everywhere see unlicensed Windows. So I will not update it because it may have a bad impact on this program, and it may stop working. Because I have updated it and it was cracked, and now I updated it and it connected to the program, reconnected to its developer, and it may stop working because you don't have it licensed. So update it only if you understand, if you are sure that this program is licensed and nothing bad will happen. For example, iTunes, I think I can update it, but, well, I don't think I will do it. Well, then we close Advanced System Care, well, and open the Driver Booster. It's the last program we will use. First, you will have this page opened. I have to translate it again. Translate it also, I think. Settings, and where is English here? English. Well. First, I don't know why it doesn't translate, so I think you will manage to find it out yourself. So, we press the start button here, and it will find all the drivers on our computer that are outdated, that we can update. So, the same as with updating the programs in the Advanced System Care, I don't recommend you to update drivers if you are not sure that you have it all licensed and it will not break anything. So, like, I updated some drivers here and my Windows has broken. So I have to reinstall it. Well, I wanted to reinstall it, man, and now I have to do it. So, well, I will make it in like a week, maybe. Well, I don't know. So the only thing I want to say here is, do not update if you are not sure that you have everything on your computer licensed and it will not break anything. So, well, you can press the update button and, well, it will update. So, the thing we need here is, it's this, speeding up the game speed up. It's the main thing that we will use in Driver Booster. It's the same to speeding up in Advanced System Care, but it works a bit better. If Advanced System Care cleans half gigabyte of memory, this program may clean like one and a half gigabytes of memory. So, well, let's test it. For example, well, I have 51% of random access memory used now. I turn on this feature. It cleans 663 megabytes and stops 11 background processes. And now I have 43%. Well. So it can be very useful because it cleans a lot of random access memory, really. So if you like play games that usually use a lot of random access memory, you have to use this feature. Not even games, but just when you work with computer, like After Effects use a lot of random access memory, so this feature will be very useful for it. So also you can close some remaining processes in the Windows resource monitor. Well, you can do it by hands. Well, and that's in fact all I wanted to tell you in this video. So if it was helpful, if it helped you to speed up your computer and increase your frames per second in game, or just efficacy of your computer resources just a bit, please subscribe the channel. Let's hit 1,000 subscribers till my birthday on 12th of September, you will really appreciate it, and it would be very great, it would be a great present for me, so make the red button under the video gray. Gray is, looks better. Well, thank you for watching this video, hope to see you next time. Press the like, press the bell button, write the comment to for me to understand what do you want a video about. So, thank you for watching, goodbye, hope to see you next time.